Jerry, great Panettieri. Yeah, you look familiar.
Well, we think we've met up in Alaska.
Yeah. No, never in Alaska.
Really?
Yeah.
For sure.
No.
They should have known if we went to Alaska.
Yeah, that's the one state on my bucket list I haven't been to.
You haven't been there?
No.
We got to get to Alaska.
Oh, I would love to come up. Yeah, that would be a thrill. Absolutely.
Great time.
Thanks. Southern California.
Okay.
I'm just trying to think of regional.
I know we've met.
Oh, definitely. You look real familiar.
No,
well, thanks for coming out.
Anybody park in the free parking spot? Yeah? Free. when you leave, I took a ticket just when you leave, just tell them the UW Allergy Journal Club and you won't pay. There's supposed to be someone standing there at exit who knows about this. If it doesn't work, you're locked in that garage.
The old dice, it could be a donation.
You can pull you.
Wasn't all that expensive.
Feedback right now.
bring one of them.
But if I unmute one of them, the feedback comes back. Okay, I think it's working here. Thanks for the
time. Yeah.
Drew.
Yeah.
This is the lady who wanted to be skin tested to broke the ball.
Does she need any more testing?
No.
Her story is that.
I'm driving his shoulder.
20 years ago.
First day. Probably that first pitch.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, no. Oh, God.
I know that.
You saw her.
We just had it.
You had a lot of colleagues. Oh, what happened?
Yeah.
I called her GI. I said, we have no test. He said, oh, just
Indian.
So,
skin test. So that was my. So anyway, the kids kind of settled down. So. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, I mean,
it's not the, you know, the problem.
Well, that's
what I told the patient. Positive kind of a good story.
I like people to come in on your job watch.
You don't know the next day. I had them avoid it just because there's other options available.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure.
There's two good antibodies.
So it's much more.
She texted later. I didn't get to my car.
test stuff. Three hands. I don't think it's free. It's okay for that. Yeah, you go behind the Boston Pizza and there's like there's nobody ever in there and there's 10 high speed chargers. I was up there this weekend and the guy was testing on the RAV4. I didn't really make it to the US or is that just a great deal?
Yeah,
it's a one of so this guy's obviously a hybrid guy because he has a Tesla.
I can't say sorry, things will or come can.
Yeah, well, yes.
He's retired now.
You young whippersnapper, you still work.
In this presentation, guys, I forgot to put it down.
Traveling wise.
No pressure.
That's right. No pressure from the invite.
Guarantee that the garage for this building will be open at 6:30. So it won't be free. It'll be $2 or $3, but it'll be accessible. So that hopefully you won't have to be driving around the neighborhood, and that'll be true for the rest of the season. The other thing is, if you're going to the Quad AI meeting and you haven't gotten an announcement so far, there's going to be a reception for our group, all our former fellows, everybody associated in any way, shape, or form with UW or Northwest Allergy at 6:30 at a restaurant called Lafayette's, walking distance from the convention center. So if you're going to go and have an RSVP, let me know, because that can guarantee a certain number of, I did guarantee a certain minimum for that evening. All right, so those are the only baseline notes. Anybody else have any comments? So really very happy to be able to introduce Dr. Ray Panettieri. When I first knew him, he was at Penn, and in a year or two ago, he could explain for himself, he moved up to be Vice Chancellor for Translational Medicine at Rutgers University in New Jersey. Now, that surprised me, because when I was at Penn, the only value New Jersey had was a conduit to Manhattan, and I'm not exactly sure why anybody would move to New Jersey, but that's a choice he can explain for himself.
Oh, great. Thank you for coming. Well, I love that. That was a great introduction. Breathtaking. So welcome, everyone. It's a thrill to be here. And actually, just wonderful friendships with Lynn and Bill and Teal here. And what you're doing is fantastic. I had the opportunity yesterday afternoon to meet with the fellows, and like always, it's energizing, because the legacy that we serve in our specialties isn't really what we do for patients or what we publish, it's who we train, because they carry on well beyond the five-year PubMed search that if your papers isn't done in 5 years, it's never quoted again. So a very important point. So, you know, Lynn wants to know, why did I go to New Jersey? Well, I really wanted to have an exit. that I could get off of. Everybody in New Jersey gets off at exits. Yes. So now I get off at exit 9. I get on at exit 6. And if you communicate in New Jersey, just speak exits, and people know exactly where you live.
That's a Jersey turnpike.
Exactly, exactly. Today what we're going to be talking about is using a technique that we have really worked at feverishly over the last 5 to 10 years. As a model system for drug discovery. And, you know, why is an academic involved in drug discovery? Because in translation of what we do in a petri dish to a patient into a community, it's really important that physician scientists have a vision that shows us, how am I going to use my best science published in high impact, but translate it into something that practitioners are going to use, and more importantly, that people will actually take. And that's quite a yeoman's task as we move forward. So with that, I will caution you that there is going to be a fair amount of cell signaling.
Oh, no. It was so nice and quiet.